Cornerbrook.
The following program is brought to you by Rogers Anyplace TV. Enjoy exclusive content for free. Visit RogersAnyplaceTV.com.
Clay Bryant.
That's the golly, I feel the
goal for your Western teams. Number 31, Noah Stimmel. Like everyone to please rise, kindly remove your hats and join in the playing of our national anthem.
Okay, back in action at the Civic Center. Game two for the Pinnacle Growlers and the hometown Western Kings. Last night was a barn burner. The Kings won it. Kings won it 5-3. Empty net goal by Elliot Dix. And A.J. Han, who was in the lineup last night, as the Kings had two players out, both out again this evening. And he scored his first in the league. And but the big star of the night was Kyle Campbell with the hat trick. So Kings are off to a start here. And there's a battle. Hiscock comes up with it. Hiscock with a shot, and it's directed to the corner by Castillo. Both teams battling back here, trying to get it out. Move by Smith. He tips it up, and that's going to be a high stick, I bet. No call. Okay, play is continuing. That's picked up by King through the slot there. Tries to slot it up to Hiscock. That goes off a skate. Butt is first on it. Hiscock is moving in. Hiscock tries to take him. Gets it up to King. King loses it in his feet momentarily. King still with it. King gets it over to Norma Wells. He dumps it back. King with it now. King slides that back over to Robinson. Robinson with the puck. Robinson goes high off the glass.
And that looks like it's going to go for a nice, no. Wobbles and stops. Smith on St. John. St. John makes a nice move.
Gets back to Hiscock. St. John with it now. Park on him. Park wearing the C, so Coach Robinson and the team must have came to some decisions this week. And congratulations to Johnny Park, captain of the reigning champion Western Kings, Freesaw Western Kings. So thanks for their sponsorship. Battling back here. Park takes his man up to Campbell. Campbell had the hat trick last night. He was the big goal scorer. He played a great game. Slides it over to the slide. There's Connors, and Connors gets it out. And there's the paddle. What a paddle it is. He was down and out. Nothing to look at but net. And Castillo got the paddle.
Okay, Ryder with it. Ryder leaves it. Walsh picks it up. That's dumped back by Dutcher. Dutcher assisted one of Campbell's goals last night. It was absolutely magnificent. Digs it out of the corner, brings it up the sidewall. He's got a man on him the whole time, and no look blind pass over to the slot, and Campbell just buries it for his third one of the night.
Here comes Walsh. Walsh skates in. He dumps it in. O'Neill's on it. Connors is on him. Kings try to get it up. Looks like Walsh might keep that in. Comes back to O'Neill. He'll get that up to, I believe that was A.J. Hand. And you can tell he's a rookie. He's awfully small. But I'll tell you, he's got a heart and a motor, and he can go. Here comes, it looks like a two-on-one. Nice hustle there by Drover to get back. Drover with it now. So Drover was trailing there, but he managed to get back into the play and take away a what could have been a real good scoring opportunity, the first one of the game. So shots on goal to start the game are 3-0 in favor of the Pinnacle Growlers. And if it wasn't for the paddle of Castillo, this game would be one up Growlers. But here we are, it's a tie. Here comes the Growlers, tries to get it up to St. John at the point, and that pass is off the mark. We got Pike playing up front tonight. So Reggie Pike coming from Labrador. He's played defense in the last four games, and he slid up here to play left wing here this evening. That comes out in front. Nice stick there. Nice stick by Drover. It slides up. Here comes out. Drover just can't pick it up. A little bobbler. Drover's in the corner. He gets knocked. Puck comes free. That comes up to Fisher. Fisher with it now. Gets it up to Witten. He loses it. Leaves it back there. Three Kings on it. Here comes Robinson. Robinson with some pressure on him. Robinson takes his time. Goes high off the glass. Gets it out of the zone. Back over to Witten. Witten with the puck now. Tries to get that. That's behind his man. Robinson comes up with it. That gets tipped off his stick. Nice try there. Here come the Kings. Here comes Smith with the puck. Smith taking his time here. Tries to slide it over. Does get it over to King. King with a nice stick to pick that up. Slides it in front. There's the tip, and a nice tip it was. So nice pass by King. Nice shot by Michael Normore Wells. Okay, so a few lineup changes for this evening. The Western Kings have Donovan Applin in the lineup tonight. So Donovan is going to be back playing defense. So that's his first action of the season. And hence, Reggie Pike has moved up to forward for tonight's game. Josh Hand is out of the lineup tonight. Josh played a great game last night for the Western Kings. On the Growlers side, there was a couple late calls in the game, so I wasn't sure what the actual call was on the whether it was going to be boarding or checking from behind. Must have been a checking from behind, so it looks like Reed Spencer's out of the lineup this evening. And so Reed Spencer, and they give away here, and there's a shot, and that's a save. Nice save by Castillo. So Reed Spencer's out, so that looks like checking from behind. And Mason Dodd, don't have the exact on that, on how many games that might be, but that was a spearing from last night. So a few lineup changes for you. Okay, so 5 minutes gone here in the first period. Kings win it. Park wins it. So that's Applin back there, 77. No name on his jersey. Playing with Jack O'Neill as a defensive partner here for this evening. With a name like Applin, I expect he's from up the coast somewhere. Lots of Applins and lots of real good hockey players up that way. And there's the shot, and that goes off the arm, so that's a nice save. Clay Ryan is your starting goaltender tonight for the Pinnacle Growlers, and he gets his real first test of this evening. Castillo's had a couple, and he's been real good, real sharp. Big question marks for the Kings on goaltending this year. The Evan Payne had moved on to Prince Edward Island, and he was a rookie last year, played really well, particularly in the playoffs. And Lucas Park, a three-year starter, was a graduating player, looking forward to the Atlantics. That didn't happen, but congratulations to him. He's moved on to Junior A and got the great news this week that he made the He made the Pictou Crushers, who won their first game of the season last night, 4-2, with two goals from Andrew Burden, also another local boy. So good on them. King's putting good pressure on here, so the looks like Wall's trying to get out of his zone. Circles back, flips it over to St. John. Nice playing by the Kings. St. John comes down with it. And there's a shot from the outside, and that goes around. Connors is going to be first on that. This one slides through, and there's a bouncing puck. Kings get it out. And that may go too far. That's going to be an ice. So that'll come all the way back. And that'll give us a chance to thank some of the sponsors. And these things just don't happen without the sponsors. So a huge commitment from the community, the business community. Brothers and Associates, gold sponsor this year. And as I mentioned last night, Kent's been a loyal supporter of the Western Kings for years. Having had a tremendous hockey career himself, eventually playing with the NCAA Division I with Michigan. Carl's Canteen, Flynn, Canada, Proactive Construction, Northwest Forest Resources, McDonald and Hoff, and Sims Financial with Sun Life. So that's just a few. We'll get back to some more, but what a great shot that was, and Castillo had to be good. So shots 5-2 in favor of the Pinnacle Growlers, and I'm going to say at least three of them were money balls. And for a Halloween night, I guess that's kind of spooky if you're a Kings fan. And oh, there's the save, and there's the goal! Ryan Reed gets the goal on the rebound. Let's take a look at the replay on this one. Okay, here's the play. Stephen Ford chasing in. And John tries to cycle it over. That comes over to Pike. Pike throws it right in front, and there you go. So Pike picks it up. He shoots it, and he's going to pick up the assist for Ryan Reed, who's there to bury it. Nice play by Pike to get that on net. Even nicer play by Reed to be in position and bury that one. Kings up 1-0. Back to the point. There's the shot. That goes off Ford's skate. Shepherd with it now. Shepherd with it again. There it goes. That goes off the stick of Castillo.
Western Kings goal, scored by number 91, Ryan Reed. Assisted by number 97, Stephen Ford. And by number 16, Reggie Pike. On the goal.
Okay, Ford picks up an assist on that one as well. And Reed from Ford and Pike at 7:35, and the Kings are leading the game, having been the winners last night, so they're going to go on their first penalty. So Pike picks up his assist, and he picks up his first penalty of the game, too. So Pike's going to go for a trip. Like the hustle. Okay, so the Growlers are going to get their first crack at the power play here this evening. There's the shot from the point, there's the save, and he just covers that up. So he controls that rebound, hangs on to the puck. Castillo has been good. He's been impressive so far this season. In the short start that we've had so far. Here's Dix on the draw. Both teams battling for it there. Gets it back up, it comes back to Walsh. Walsh keeps it in. Walsh dumps it down. There's the shot from Witten, and that's blocked. There's the shot from Witten again, and that goes off a player and in the net, and not a chance for Castillo on that one. Not sure who that hit. We'll take a look here, but it does hit a player right in front, so I'm not sure if it's Witten's goal or... comes up to Witten. Witten with the shot, and that's going to be his goal. That goes right off Hoff. So that hits Hoff and knuckles right into the net, so Witten picks it up. We got a tie game. The Growlers are 1-for-1. Here's Hiscock. Hiscock with an out. Hiscock comes in. He scored a pretty one last night. Smith gets over. He gets there, knocks it down the ice. think the Kings thought that they were still killing a penalty here, so that one squirts down, and Clay Ryan doesn't play it, so that goes for an ice. Okay, so we got Dyke, and there comes through, and then picked it up by Hiscock and drops it back. Nice play by Hiscock. O'Neill with it. That goes up. Both teams battling here. Okay, it's going to be picked up by Applin. Applin making his first start in the league. O'Neill slides it up to King. That goes off his skate over to Dyke. Dyke couldn't handle it. This one's dumped out. St. John just dumps that back in. Good play by him. Nothing but trouble the other way. And this one is going to be dumped out through and picked up by King. King with it now. King slides it over. King with the move. King still with the puck. Back to O'Neill. O'Neill with the shot. There's the tip. And Smith bangs it off him. And that goes off. I think that goes off Ryan. Nice save by him. That's kept down. St. John. St. John and Smith battling here in the corner. Still, both teams still battling. Hiscock with it. They're knocking each other around down there. Normal Wells comes up with it. Slides it over to there's a tip, and a nice tip it was. That's Dutcher. That was power with the shot. Tip by Dutcher. And that goes off another stick, so that just gets off the tip. Directed to the corner. And there's a shot, and that goes off a leg, and Castillo was in position to save that. Nice play by him. Walsh makes the move. That's broken up. Dumped back in. Drover's going to be first on it. King's battling here, trying to get this out. He does. Comes down to Walsh. Johnny Park on him. Park with a good forecheck. Both lose their legs on that one. Park comes up with it. Back to the point. Over to Power. Power tries to slide it over to Drover. That's off the mark. He dumps it back in for Dutcher. Dutcher gets it over to Park. Park with the sharp angle. Dumps it back. Nice play by Park. Puck bobbles and Power can't handle that one. Park gets it over to Drover. Kings are looking for a change here. Get some fresh legs out. Kyle Campbell. So big loss for the Growlers tonight in Reed Spencer. He's a third-year defenseman. And defense is one of the toughest positions to fill. So interesting to see how Applin does here this evening. He's number 77. And there's a pass. And that's going to go for a nice. It doesn't get tipped. The puck just popped right over Reed's stick, and he was on his way to the goal. He controlled that one. So Stephen Ford with it. Stephen wins the draw. Comes up the pike. Pike tries to play that out. Nice stick there by St. John to keep that in. Connors with it. With a move by Connors. Nice play by Robinson. Just tips it up. Reed with it. Takes his time. Gets the red line before he dumps it in. Reggie Pike tries to slide that over back to Reed. Reed with a shot. And that goes, wow. That boy can shoot a puck. Speaking of which, for the goal scorer, I'd like to give a big shout out to Becky Reed, who's over in Andy Ganesh. So that's Ryan's sister. So we're developing an interprovincial following. So that's good to see more fans. So I hope you're not having too spooky of a night over there, Becky. And that's picked up by Robinson. Robinson now tries to make the move, controls the puck. Gains the line, dumps it in. Nice play. And Martel is going to get the call. So I thought Robinson lost his feet, but not only did he lose his feet, he probably had a stick intertwined in them. So Martel's off to the sin bin. The Kings are on a power play. 7 minutes left to go here in the first period. All knotted at one. Growlers lead it in the shots category, 11-6. Both goalies have been tested. Markovic here. Park wins it. Nice hustle by Park. That was a good third effort on his part. There's the tip. Another tip by Dutcher. That's two. Keeps doing that. He's going to find some success. King just about loses. That could have been dangerous. O'Neill with it.
There's the tip again. Nice try. Back up to King. King with it. King gives it over to O'Neill. O'Neill tries to slide that over, and Kyle Campbell uses his feet.
Oh, and a nice play there by Vich. He just gets around him. O'Neill looks like he's going to hook him, and he does. And that is just a hook, so no penalty shot there. Saying he wasn't free and clear, so O'Neill looked committed to the hook right from the start. He managed to get him. So anyway, that'll nullify the power play. The Growlers theoretically would go on a power play where 31 seconds left in both of these. Okay, so a little four-on-four hockey here. Kyle Campbell, Normal Wells, and Smith bobbles it and gets it outside the line. St. John with it. St. John, that goes off a stick. Shepherd with it now. Shepherd gets it back to St. John.
2 minutes for hockey.
That comes up through. That's Walsh. Walsh with it, and that gets dropped back for Dyke. There's the shot, and that goes wide. Puts it there first. He takes a knock. Does not get it out. Back to Drover. Drover makes a move. Still has it. Nice play by Drover. Passes that up to Smith. Smith with Wells. Well, and that goes right off his stick and back to Drover. There's a tip, and that comes in, so there's no ice on that. It's going to be played right on the net. Ryan plays it over. St. John with the puck here now. St. John dumps that back. Over to Shepherd. Smith pursuing him. Shepherd with it. Shepherd gets that up to Walsh. Walsh takes a knock. It's dumped back down. Robinson picks it up. Robinson with it now. Gets it over to the corner. That's going to go to Drover. Drover with it now. Looks for Park. Gets it up to Park. Park takes a knock. Keeps the center of gravity low there. He handled that pretty easy. Slides it over. And what a play. And he scores! What a play! So Michael Normal Wells gets the goal. Great play by the captain, Johnny Park. And they're going to hang on to that puck. I think that might be Normal Wells' first goal in Major Midget Hockey. So look at this play here by Park. Slides it over, and Normal Wells scores it. Does exactly what you're supposed to do. Goes to the net. Great play by Park. Great play by Wells to pick up his first U18 Major Midget Hockey League goal. Gets his first one during COVID. Kings lead it 2-1. Here come the Growlers. He gets knocked off that by Park. Park's had a great shift out here, making his presence felt. Back down to Drover. That goes off a stick, tries to get it over to Campbell. That bounces off Park, picked up by Hiscock. Hiscock slides that down. 15 seconds left to go here in this power play. Okay, Drover picks up an assist on that as well. So good hustle for the Kings. O'Neill's out of the box, so we're back to even strength. King tried to slide that up, and that's going to go for an ice. Again, I think they thought they were still killing a penalty here. So 4 minutes and 24 seconds to go. Shots on goal are 12-9 in favor of the Growlers. Score is 2-1 in favor of the Kings. Here's the draw. Growlers looked like they had a chance at it. Butt with it now. Butt just fans on it. Comes up to Dix. Dick slides that up. Ryder picks it up. Ryder dumps it in. That goes into the corner. Noftel's first on it. Teams battle back there. Connor's there with the puck now. Okay, there goes a stick flying. So Hoff loses his stick. Got it back. Here comes Hand. Hand slides it up to Dix. Oh, Gould, sorry. There's Dixon. Tries to flick it over into Hoff. Gould with it now. Gould gets that back up to the point. There's the shot by Butt, and that's blocked by Noftel. Martel with it now. Nifty little move there. Slides it up to Connors. Connors picks it up with his skates. Forwards it up to Noftel. Nice play by him. Nice stick there by Robinson. So I'm impressed with Robinson. He's made some nice plays here this evening. Here comes Stephen Ford. Almost a two-on-one. There's the shot, and that's handled. So Ryan gloves that, makes it look easy. And we'll get a face-off in the Growler zone with 3 minutes and 22 seconds left. So yeah, just to mention a few more of the gold sponsors, L&G Trucking, Bloodworks, Marcus Construction, March Family Dental, All Tech Environment, and Belfour. Growlers win the draw. It comes up to the... up to the side ball. Both teams battling here. Back to O'Neill. O'Neill takes the shot, and Ryan can see that all day, but doesn't have it. Pike is in there. Pike trying to make his presence felt. First time up this season with the Kings as a forward. Played defense the first four games and played very well, I might add. Comes Applin. Applin tries to get it out. Over to Ford. Ford with it now. Ford just dumps that in. That's going to be played by Ryan. Reed is on it. Leaving St. John back there. Comes back up. Grover with it. And that's going to be held and should bring us a face-off. So both teams are going to make some changes. Face off there by Vich, wins it. Ryder with it. He's got some pressure on him. Does get it up to Walsh. Walsh slides it up to Ryan. John Ryan. There was a movie series, John Ryan, wasn't there? I can't remember who that was. That's the Jack Ryan. That's right. Okay, here's Smith with it. Smith with a shot. That's another save by Ryan. He's good with the glove. He's had them all night if you can see them. Now taking the lead in shots. They're 14-2. Michael Norman Wells here on the draw. He wins that. Back to Drover. Drover with the shot. That goes off. Oh, that goes off, King. And just about sneaks into the net. And back to Drover again. There's the shot. Nice blocker by Ryan. He's been good out here. Ryder. Ryder gets it up to Walsh. Walsh, nice stick there by nice stick by King. Smith leaves it for him. How you doing? Under 2 minutes here to go in this first period. Kings lead it 2-1. Walsh with the puck here now. Walsh tries to make a move. Smith got it. Smith with a shot. He centers it. And Normore Wells almost had a second one. Nice hustle by Wells to get back in the play. Here's the shot. And that comes off. And that goes off another stick. So good shift here by the Kings. Generating some opportunities. Can't bury them. Comes Robinson. Robinson just misses Dutcher. That slides back, picked up by Shepard. Shepard over to St. John. St. John gets that up to, tries to get it over to Dyke. That goes off his stick. Campbell with it now. Campbell dumps that back down to Park. Park with the puck. Park back up to the point. Back to Robinson. Robinson sizing it up. Back to Park. King showing some nice patience here. Play by St. John, cuts off Dutcher. That goes sliding around the boards here. O'Neill looks to be able to keep that in. Gets it back down to Campbell. Campbell with a shot. Gets it. Oh! That was a little trick, so. Campbell with it now. Down to the corner. 40 seconds left to go here in this period. Gets it back up. Park is on it. Let's tip back in. Look, delay it offside. Here comes Shepard up through. A nice play by Park. He just comes back and puts his shoulder down and then loses it. And there's the save, so another nice save by Castillo. So Park comes down, puts his shoulder on him, separates his man from his puck in open ice. And a nice clean play and just happened to lose it at the last second. Okay, 10 seconds left here. O'Neill dumps that off the boards. That goes banging around. Here comes Park. Park with 5 seconds, tries to get up the hop, and that should do it for the first period. So... Okay, shots on goal are 19-13 in favor of the Western Kings. So they were being outshot here the first 5-10 minutes, and the Kings came to life. So Kings lead it on the scoreboard. And just want to thank some silver sponsors, Northwest Forest Resources, Williams Building Supply, Jarvis Refrigeration, Ang Safety, Vich's Ultramar, and some bronze sponsors, Langer's, John Kitely, Pool Althouse Law, Pizza the Light Stephenville, The Medicine Shop in Deer Lake, Western Woodworks, Sean Hickey Rentals, Luxury Limousines, Scotch Transport, Bud's Auto Body, Western Lock, and Steers Insurance. So thank you to all the sponsors that come out. It means a big deal to the Kings and to our community. So we'll be back. See you here in the second period.
Thank you.
lead it 2-1. The out-of-town score after one. Tri-Pan is leading the East Coast Blizzard 3-1. And Tri-Pan dropped their first one to the Blizzards last night, 6-3. So Blizzards got into the Will column, and this is right out in front, and that's directed into the corner. So pretty impressive opportunity there for Witten. Here comes Johnny Park. Johnny's struggling to get it through. Here he does. He battles it out. He has it now. Park with it. Park tries to slide it in. Nice stick there. Back up to the point. Drover with it. Drover slide. There's a tip, and he almost scores. So Park has been playing a heck of a game and gutting it out and making the plays that he needs to. So player of the game so far for Wester. Here comes Witten. Witten slides in. There's the shot, and that goes wide. Using Strap as a decoy, and this one comes out to Smith. Smith coming in, gets it back to Park. Park with the shot that goes off the wall, bounces back out. Smith gets it over to him again. That goes off a stick, and this is going to be just flicked down the ice. Comes O'Neill. O'Neill with the puck now. O'Neill makes his move. O'Neill gets it up to King. King with it. King dumps that in. Norm Wells is going to be on that. Bounces his man off. Bounces off Shepard. Smith with it. Smith takes it down low. He's got King with him. Tries to slide that in front. Loses it. Connor's with it now. This goes off the boards. Robinson. Robinson dumps that back down. Shepard's going to be first on it. He's getting pressure from King.
Don't forget, folks, to get your 50-50 tickets for tonight's game.
St. John with it. Gets it over. Noftal is on it. Noftal is swinging a miss. And here comes Norm Wells coming down. He dumps that in. King is there. That goes behind the net. Shepard plays it. Noftal. Nice break up there by Hoff. Hoff skates in, coming off the bench. Nice stick there by Hoff. And that goes up and into the boards. And we'll get a break in play here. So I want to give a big shout out to two parents in town. We want to talk about the commitment from the Labrador contingent. I know there's a big contingent out in Central, but the couple of kids with the Western team, Jake Vallis and Reggie Pike, they're both their dads came in the weekend. 16-hour drive. 16-hour drive down from Lab City to the ferry. Looked like it wasn't going to cross. It did. And finally made their way to the game last night. And Chris Vallis got to see Big Jake, his son, get his second win in major midget action, and he's sporting a 2.5 goals against average to start the season. And Reggie Pike, so Kirk Pike, Reggie's dad, traveled down with Chris, and Reggie picks up an assist, played defense last night, picks up an assist on the first goal to Reed, and nice play by him, heads up, sharp, nice shot from the corner. And we got offsides here, so Growlers are going to be offsides. That'll come back out. Okay, so your officials this evening is McCarthy and Colburn. McCarthy and Colburn are wearing the stripes. And we've got Aaron Purcell-Pilgrim and Kyle George as your linesmen this evening. So credit to them. They've done a great job here so far. That goes for an ice. So yeah, it was a great game last night. Kings start the season at 3-1. Got a 2-1 lead here in this game. Growlers are 0-1 to start their season after getting off the bus last night. It's always tough with the bus legs. Here comes Ryan Reed. He tries to get it over to Pike. Pike is going to be first on it. Riders in on him, slides that across, and that was tricky. That goes off the stick, but Ryan is flashing the leather again. So Clay Ryan with another glove save. Sharp angle. Okay, so we got Ford centering Reed and Pike on this line. So this comes back to Applin. Applin with a shot. That gets blocked. That's hit from outside the red line, and that's going to go down, and we do get an ice on that. So Walsh was first on it, but not quick enough to prevent the icing. The Interestingly enough, when we give the shout out to the first goal for Ryan Reed to his sister Becky, she's a previous Western Warrior, was a member of the provincial team and studying at St. Evex this year. So you know, we've produced some pretty impressive girls in this province, and certainly from the West Coast. And there's Stephen Ford, and that one's handled by Ryan. That gets up to Walsh. Walsh with the puck here now, coming down on O'Neill. O'Neill keeps into the outside. Nice play by O'Neill. O'Neill takes the body. Nice, comes back up to the point. There's the shot. No tip there. Ryan Reed with it. Ryan gets that up to Pike. Oh, and he just misses it. Pike was off to the races, and now he's going to be off to the bench. That's a nice in, and we'll get fresh legs out here. So just better than 3.5 minutes gone here in the second period. Shots on goal are really skewed now in favor of the Kings, 21-13. Some big chances early for the Growlers, and Castillo was just incredible, right? Makes three great saves, one with a paddle, which was a sure goal, and he just misses the open net. Not sure how he missed that one. I am sure Witten would love to have that one back. He was wide open. Everybody thought the play was going the other way. That was a little hocus pocus here on Halloween. A little trickery for sure. Spooky for the Kings. Spooky, spooky. Okay, here's Park on the draw. Park and Witten. Park wins it. He's been good. Gets that up. Here's Campbell. Campbell tries to dump it off the boards. That's kept in by Witten. That comes down. Bouncing around. Robinson with it now. Robinson shoots that off. Kept in again by Witten. He's off the boards. Ryder's on it. Oh, and he gets hit. He cops up right away. So that was in the numbers. Again, don't like to see those hits. We had one of them last night, and as a result, Reed Spencer's sitting this one out. And I think that's going to be a boarding. Steven Ryder was up pretty quick on that play, so he didn't get hurt, but dangerous play altogether. Okay, so Kings are going to be killing the penalty here for a couple. Drover with it. Drover gets it. Good pressure here by the... That's kept in. It's kept in by Shepherd. Shepherd gets it over to St. John. St. John gets it back over to Shepherd. Shepherd slides it down to Connors. Connors looking for the outside. Nice stick there by Drover. Drover smacks that one. That comes up to the point. Goes off St. John. Ben Smith is skating down on this. Going to be played by Clay Ryan. Ryan's going to play that over to Shepherd. That comes back to Noftel, and they're regrouping, so they've killed 35 seconds here. There's the play, and that goes over. Misses the stick. Kings get it back out again. Here's Noftel with it now. Noftel tries to play it. He does. Gets that up to Martel. Martel tries to slide it back to Shepherd. That's going to come outside the line. Here come the Kings again. That one slides over to the other side. Drover with it now. Drover gets it up to Smith. Smith tries to make a move. Here comes Norman Wells. He does make a move. Wells with it. Oh, and that goes off the stick of Connors. And King's got to be getting tired here, looking for a change. There's Connors with a shot, and that goes wide. Smith with it now. Back up to Witten. Sorry, that's to Walsh. Into Noftel. That's broken up. We got players falling down here. There's the shot, and that goes wide. Got a couple sticks down there. Tries to get it back up to the point, and that goes to Noftel. Goes to St. John. St. John with the shot, and Costello just misses that. And we've got a net issue. Okay, the play's blown dead here. Not sure what the call was. 19 seconds left to go in the Campbell boarding call. A little bit of chatter. Probably asking each other if they're going out trick-or-treating tonight. There's Ryder with it. Ryder with a shot. And it's screened in front. That goes off a skate and just dies. So I think it hits Dyke's skate, drops down. Kings clear it out. Dix is on this one. Hoff is pinching in. He gets it. Comes over to Hiscock. Hoff is right on him. Nice play by Hoff. Hicks is going after him, and Hoff is working down there. And hustle by Hoff. Dix is on him now. That's Walsh with it. Ryder picks it up. He flicks that across ice. That comes right to Hiscock. O'Neill takes a run at him, and it's a swing and a miss, essentially.
Would like to thank tonight's gold sponsor, Carol's Canteen.
And that does hit and goes skating down, and that's going to go for an icing. Penalty's over. Back to even strength here. So 13-14 left to go here in the second period.
Savings Financial, Sunlight, Mills Trucking, Floodworks, Marcus Contracting, Merch Family Dental, Altec Environmental, and Belfour.
Okay, 13-14 to go here. We got Ford and Dyke on the draw. Dyke wins it. O'Neill picks it up. Tries to clear that out. Kept in by Ryder. That comes down, goes to the corner. Kaplan's on him. And gets back. Over to Hiscock. Back to Hiscock. With a shot, and that's right in the bread basket. Nice save there. O'Neill takes a little offense to that, so he gives a baby tap to Walsh there, just expressing his displeasure. Back up to the point, there's a shot by Shepard. That's a skate save. Skate save there by Castillo. Castillo's 1-1 on the year. Lost the season opener out in Windsor Stadium last Friday night, and two Fridays ago, and was the winner on Sunday morning, played an excellent game, won that game 5-2. So he's got a 3 goals against average going into this game, and 1-1 on the season. Nice play, nice pressure here by Pike on St. John. Gets it up, nice pass there. Gets it over to John Ryan. This game's gonna make a change, get some fresh legs here on the ice. Okay, play comes down. St. John with it. Puts it over to Shepard. Shepard plays that up to Strap. Strap tries to send that over to Stevenson. That misses. Nice stick there by Power. Power keeps that. We had Strap. Michael Strap is going to be wide open on that, walking in. Nice play there. Nice passing by the Growlers here. Real nice plays. That does get broken up. Power's going to get that outside. Power has it now. Power skates it in. Power flicks it over to Campbell. Campbell with the shot, and that's blocked by Witten. Nice block by Witten. Back up to Park on the point. Park dumps that down. St. John gets it up high, and that goes over two, and it's a 2-on-1 here. Park is skating back. Nice hustle by Park. Park comes back, and he picks up the puck, so... Johnny Park having a heck of a hockey game here. Hasn't scored a goal, got an assist, and he's been playing like a trooper all night. He's all over the place. Off the limb there, Park on him. Grover steps in. Park picks it up. Park looking for a man open, nobody there. Gets it back over to Dutcher. Dutcher now with it. Skating up the sideball, tries to get that up, and that's going to go too far. Campbell. And that'll go for an icing. So, some of those passes this evening have been off the mark, particularly on the breakout through neutral ice, trying to hit the open man. And a little bit of cleanup for the Kings next week when they get back to practicing. Practice? Are you talking about practice? One of my favorite sports lines. So here's Norman Wells on the draw for the Kings. Loses that to Martel. That's kept in by Ryder. Knopfler with it now. Knopfler gets it out in front. He scores! Nice play, nice pass. We'll take a look at this one again. I believe that's Connors with the goal. So here's the play down in the corner. Slides it out, and that just goes five hole, and we got a tie hockey game. So nice play there by Nostal. So that's going to be Nostal to Connors. But even the start of that play, coming back out of their own end, when originally that was coming down, was the Growlers showing some pretty impressive passing there. So we got a tie hockey game, and we're about halfway through this one. So fitting on this Halloween evening, which almost feels not quite February weather, but it's certainly beginning of January weather. It's cold out here. So that comes out of the zone. O'Neill's going to pick that up. O'Neill for the Kings. He'll get it over to Normal Wells. He loses it. Nice stick there by Dyke, and Castillo's going to want to see a face-off here. Let the Kings regroup. And some fresh legs out here for the Western Kings. Okay, we got Vitch and Elliot Dix. Dix wins it. Robinson with it. Rob's a big, strong boy. That goes flicking down the ice. Gould is going to be on that, and it doesn't get there fast enough. So exactly at the halfway mark. So the Kings lead it on the... So Connors from Nostal and Martel on the goal. So Connors from Nostal and Martel. And... And nice play by Martel, nice play by Nostal, and a great shot there by Connors. So can't take that away from them. Here's Robinson with it. Gets it up to Dix. Dix tries to slide it over to Gould. St. John is going back there. Nice hustle by Gould. Vitch picks it up. And Dix was coming in on him. Looked like that could have been a trip, but he decided to move out of the way. Nice play there by O'Neill. Keeps his man. Look at that. Get the hand up in the face and no call on that one. Gould with it. Gould gets it outside. Dix flicks it up, and that's going to be too far as well. So just missing the mark on those. So it's been a few of those plays. A few of those plays this evening. Just trying to get that puck chipped up and give the forward a chance to skate to it, and it just goes too far. So that's coming all the way back. Martel and Ford here on the draw. Picked up by Connors. Scored the second goal here this evening. Martel with it. Martel looking around, slides it out, and another nice play by Martel over to Nostal. And that goes right in the back of the net. So nobody picks up Nostal on that one. Nice pass by Martel over to Nostal. Okay, that's it. 3-2 Growlers, and the shots on goal are tied at 21. The 20th and 21st shot for the Growlers were golden. Power with it now. Power tries to get that up there. Martel with it. He's been good here tonight. Martel gets to it first. Martel with the puck. Martel slides that in front. Nice stick there by Power. Nostal was looking for another one, and there's another pass that just goes too long. It's going to go for an ice. Okay, so Martel from Connors and Martel. And that's the combination that scored the last two goals. So here it is. Here's O'Neill. O'Neill gets it up to Smith. Loses that in his feet. That goes high. It's going to be picked up by Normal Wells, and we got a 2-on-1. Here's the shot, and there's the save, and he just covers that up. A minor pushing. Mm-hmm. Okay, so good play there by the Kings, and get the face off down in the offensive end. Got Witten and Norma Wells here on the draw. And we've got it looks like an equipment issue. So Dutcher goes to the dressing room. There's the shot, and that gets blocked. That one's flicked, and that just goes wide. St. John is first on it. That goes off Smith's stick. That was intended for Stevenson. This one gets flicked in, so that's dumped in. Applin is going to be there. Gets it over to Smith. Smith tries to tip it out. Stevenson back up, and that could be dangerous. Kings are giving up a lot of opportunities here in the dangerous territory. Nathan King, nice play there. So great stick. Smith tries to get it back to O'Neill. So Nathan King comes there and makes the move, and it's quite the play. One on four here. Smith with it, loses that. Another tip of the stick. So that's St. John, I believe, with that play. So St. John really broke that one up. Nathan King was sliding in there, and he's got, like I said, he's got the best hands in the league. And there's a rebound, and there's another rebound. They're sitting there. King flicks this up. Hoff loses his feet momentarily. Dix picks it up. Steals it coming in through the slot. St. John tries to get that up, broken up by Drover. And Hiscock takes a swing at him, and a swing and a miss. Hoff with it now. Hoff trying to come in over the line. I think this is the best period of hockey we've seen out of the Growlers so far. So they played five periods here at the Cornbrook Civic Center, and I'd have to say this is easily their best period. Drover now gets it back to Robinson. Robinson with it. Got Hiscock on him. Battling with Dyke. He's back out to the slot. It's just sitting there. Dix with it now. Dix to Hiscock. Hicks gets it back over to the side. That comes in. That goes high. Let's flip that out around. Gould with it now. Walsh with it. Walsh with the puck. Walsh coming down. There's the shot. That goes off Drover. Nice block by him. Walsh back to Walsh. It's down to Dyke. Dyke skating after it. Drover's going to get there first. Gets it up to Reed. Ryan Reed flicks it back. That comes to the point. And there's a nice little tip attempt. Goes off the side of the net. That's a goal for your Growlers. So that's the second one of the night for Dyke. And he just comes around. Like I said, they've been playing a heck of a period. They seem to have, they've got more legs at this point than they've had since they've arrived in Cornerbrook. So Western Kings are going to need to pick it up here. Down two goals here in the second period. And they've been outplayed here in the second period. Unassisted. So Dyke gets the goal. This one comes up to Applin. Applin shoots it back down. Pike is battling for it. Comes back up to Applin. Applin takes the shot, and there's a tip. A nice save there by Ryan. This one comes down, and that's going to go for an ice. So 5:04 left here to go in the second period. Kings down by two. Came into this period with a one-goal lead. Gave up three. Okay, Park on the draw. He wins it. Back over to Power. Power slides it down. Park picks it up. Ryan Reed with it. There's the shot. That's handled easily by Ryan. That's Vince with the puck.
He's battling back there. There's more jump in the Growler's step here. This one's kept into the corner by Power. Gets it over to Ryan Reedy, misses it. Back to the point, there's the shot, there's the tip. Nice save there by Castillo, and this one slides in front. So they're making those passes right in the front, right out into the slot, and doing that fairly regularly with little disruption. So 4:21 left to go here in the second period. The Kings would like to get one back before this break, having walked into the period with a one-goal lead. Okay, no more Wells on this one. Him and Martel. Wells gets tossed. Okay, that goes for an icing. It's gonna come all the way back here and get no more Wells and Martel here on the on drop. Okay, Martel battling back there. Nice hustle there. O'Neill comes in. There was a swing and a miss, and there's a bit of a suplex. And not sure what exactly all the calls are going to be here, but O'Neill is still struggling to get up. Not sure if a suplex is a 2 minute minor or four. Okay, it looks like Martel's going to the box. Okay, just sorting out. Kings are going to go on the power play here. Martel's gone to the box for two. This might be the spark the Kings need for the second period. Let's see if they can produce here on this power play. Reed with it now. Reed gets it back up to King. King looking. Kings gets it down to Park. Park gets it in. Tips by Campbell. And that's handled by Shepherd. Shepherd sends it the length of the ice, and Castillo is playing with it. There's O'Neill. O'Neill gets it up to Park. Minute 30-ish left to go here in this power play. Park dumps it in. King is going to be down there. St. John comes up with it, and that's not held in by O'Neill. Swung back to Reed. Ryan Reed misses on that one, trying to get it over to Campbell. Reed picks it back up. O'Neill with it. O'Neill dumps that in. And like I said last week, the dump and chase. The big thing about the dump and chase is the chase part. Okay, banging around, and it looks like a shorthanded opportunity momentarily. So Campbell with it now. King struggling to get this in the get this set up, get in the zone here. So King with it here at center ice. That goes off a stick. Witten looked like he may have had an opportunity for a second. Stevenson on it. Stevenson with the puck now. Stevenson, and we got bodies coming through, and 30 seconds left to go here in the power play. And that's going to go for an ice, so that'll get some fresh legs out on the ice. But tough looking start to that power play. 25 seconds left. Let's see if the Kings can regroup. Okay, no more Wells, and I think that's Vich. Kings come up with it. Robinson with it now. 20 seconds left to go in the power play. We'll just break out going here. That goes behind Normore Wells. Drover with the puck. Gets it back to Robinson. 10 seconds left to go in the power play. Good pressure there by Vich. Gets it over to Normore Wells. Normore Wells coming up through neutral ice there. That gets knocked off, and that's going to get dumped back in. And that may go for, nope. I guess they said that was too slow. Here comes Robinson. So teams are back to even strength. 1:40 to go here in the period. Robinson crosses the blue line. Robinson with the shot, and that goes right in the bread basket, and that's held by Ryan. He's been good here. Okay, face off in the Growlers zone. Fisher on the draw. He loses that to Normore Wells. Back to Robinson. Robinson slides that down. Smith battling for it. Smith comes up with it. Comes up on the sidewall. Smith with it. Smith tries to dump that back down to Normore Wells. That's gotten outside the line. Drover with it now. Drover knocks it back, and that's picked up. And that's not what you wanted if you're a Kings fan. So Brady Walsh. A little bit of pushing and shoving on the go here. So Brady Walsh with the goal. It's 5-2. Nice shot. We'll give him that. Comes in, bobbles it. And there's the shot. And that just beats Castillo, who's been great here all night. So some words being exchanged here. Probably talking about their costumes for later. So, 1:13 left, and in all the periods I've seen so far for the Western Kings this year, this must be the most disappointing one from if you're Coach Robinson. Kings came into this with a one-goal lead, and looked like they're going to walk out of it down 3. And so it'll be gut check time coming into the third period. See what happens in that dressing room. See what they can do here. Are they going to roll over? Are they going to fight back in this one? So Ford battling for it here. Gets that up. Dix tries to get it. Dix does come up with it. Dix with the puck. Nice play there by Vich. Here comes Ford. Nice save there by Ryan. Comes back up to the point. That's kept in by Applin. Pike is first on it. Pike tries to slide that over. That O'Neill can't keep that one in. And we got a 2-on-1 coming back the other way. 2-on-1, and that just nice stick there by Applin. Mike putting some pressure on Vich here, 30 seconds to go. That gets knocked off his stick by Pike, that gets dumped back down. Here's Pike with it now. Pike takes his move, takes his time, takes the shot, and that goes off a stick over the glass, or over the net. Pike battling. Pike with the puck. Ford's going to jump in. Pike still with it. Pike slides that over. And looks like we're going to have a penalty here. So Ford, and there's a push or a punch. Not sure what that was. Saw a stick come up, so we'll be interested to see what the call is on this. McCarthy's down there with his arm up. Looks like St. John's going to the box, and Fordy's going to the box as well. So Stephen Ford for the Kings and St. John for the Growlers. Yeah. I missed the first one there, but the second one was a cross check. So I think Ford got the cross check. And roughing on St. John. So I think they're both a little lucky there. I saw at least a swing and a miss and a high stick. So 2-2 is not a bad way to settle this down. This should end it. 3.8 seconds left here in the 3.8 seconds left here in the second period. 5-2 shots on goal are 28-26 in favor of the Growlers. Okay, Park gets tossed. Smith comes in. Nope, Smith throws back over, and Power's coming in to take the draw here. And there's the shot, and that goes off the stick, and that'll do it for the second period.
Growlers penalty to number 13, Ryan St. John. 2 minutes for roughing. Time of the penalty, 1957. Kings King's penalty to number 97, Steve Ford. 2 minutes for cross-checking. Time of the penalties, 1957. That's St. John. We'll be right back.
in.
Okay, back here for the third period.
And number one, Jake Bellows.
Okay, we got Stephen Ford still in the box here, along with St. John on the penalties to end that third period. So we got a goaltending change for the start of the third. So big Jake Vallis is back in nets, and so he'll be relieving Castillo. So unfortunate for Castillo. I'm sure he's disappointed, but he shouldn't hang his head on that. He really did keep the Kings in it in the first period. And it's a team game out there, and Kings didn't offer up a lot of help in the second. So let's see if they can dig down and get back in this game here. It's played by Ryder. That comes around. Campbell's battling for it there. Campbell takes a spill. Sticks are going flying. Connors with it. Connors dumps that out. That comes to O'Neill. Neil having an eye, gets it over to Campbell. Campbell makes the turn. Campbell's coming in. There's the shot. There's the save. And that goes into the glove of Ryan, which has been a good glove all night. Okay, let's see if the Kings can get on the board here, see what they can do. 19-12. Smith on that. Smith is there first. Battling back there. That comes out, and there it comes right across, and that's almost got over to King. Powers first back. He's being pursued there. Witten comes up with it. That was close. That was offside, so delayed offside call there. Pass up to Smith. Smith with it now. Smith coming down on Wall. Smith tries to make the move. King picks it up. King gets it back up to the point. Power with it. Power dumps it back down to King. King with the puck now. Smith comes down. Comes back up to Robinson. Robinson with a shot, and there's the glove of Ryan again. He's going to have that thing worn out by the end of the night. Shots are 28-28, 5-2 is the score. Fresh legs coming out here for both teams. Dix with it. Dix picks it up. Dix tries to send it across, and there's a try and attempted tip there by Pike. That one goes flying. That should go for an ice. That does. Vallis plays it behind his net. And that's going to come all the way back. Okay, the Kings have Elliot Dix, Ryan Reed, and Reggie Pike out here. And my understanding is the Kings are down a couple bodies, so we've got a couple undisclosed injuries here to Keegan Butt and Liam Dutcher. So big loss there. So Kings a little short-handed at the moment. Slides up to Reed. Reed just tips that. Mike is going in on it. He's coming down with Ryder. That gets flicked over. Nice movement there by the Growlers to relieve that pressure and get it back out. O'Neill picks it up.
The hockey ticket number, the next stoppage in play.
Ryan with it, John Ryan. And that's going to be a high stick, so O'Neill's going to go to the box for a high stick on that. I don't think he tried it, but he did get it up. And touches the puck, shoots that around, and Kings are going to go back on the penalty kill here. So penalties are over to St. John and Ford, and O'Neill's gonna have a seat on that one. A little unlucky on that play. Okay, so we got Robinson, Drover, Smith, and Normor Wells out here for the Kings. We've got Vitch, Fisher, Noftel, and Shepard out here for the power play for the Growlers. There's a shot from St. John. That goes wide. Omar Wells gets it up. Smith is there. Smith is coming back with St. John. St. John touches it first. Smith still on him, battling back there. Good hustle by him. Smith still with it. St. John picks it up. And that one there goes wide. So good pressure there by the Kings. That comes back into the zone. Robinson gets there first. Robinson with the puck. Robinson shoots that down. That's going to be played by Ryan. Ryan with it now. Going to leave that for St. John. St. John with it. Gets that up to Robinson. Robinson gets knocked off that puck. Shepard with it. Shepard leaves it for Noftel. Noftel brings it down to the corner. Martell is on it. He gets knocked by Robinson. Robinson's a big boy. Connors is there. Michael Normor Wells tipped in front, and we've got two speedsters coming here. It's going to be a penalty, so that's going to be either a hook or interference. So that's going to be a hook. So nice hustle there by Normor Wells. He put on a burst of speed along with Dix, and St. John didn't have much choice but to give him a hook there. So 42 seconds left in the O'Neill penalty. So Kings will get a power play with minute 18 if everything goes according to plan. 4-on-4 hockey till then. There's Kyle Campbell. That goes off the side of the net. Growlers break it out. Walsh with it. Walsh skating down. That's tipped to the corner by King. Power loses his feet. He gets a little knock. Here comes Connors. Connors with it now. Connors behind the net. Nice stick there by King. King comes up with it. King flicks that. That goes off the stick and outside the blue line. 10 seconds left essentially here. 10 seconds left in the penalty for a little bit of a power play. That goes right off the stick. Right chases it right up, and nice play there by Johnny Park, knocking Reed down. Ryder down. comes Connors. Connors with it now. Kings on a power play. Connors still with it. Connors going for a skate. Kings want that puck back. Connors still with the puck. Normore Wells gives him a knock. He does get it up to Noftel. So nice pass by him. Nice play by Noftel. And what a play by Robinson. So Big Jake looked like he was down and out. And Noftel was ever dangerous. Here comes Normore Wells. It's kept in by King. Normore Wells with the puck here now. Slides that over. Gets that down to the corner. That passes off to Mark Dyke. King turns the wrong way. And that comes outside the zone. And that's Witten on him. Witten battling for it there. 30 seconds left to go here in the power play. Gets it up to Smith. Smith with the puck. Smith tries to make the move, and he does. Tries to slide it over, and he had Normore Wells skating in there, so nice play by the defenseman. 14 seconds left. Drover with it. Drover with the puck, tries to get that up to Smith. That goes off a stick. Smith makes the move. Ryan Reed's got it. Tries to get it back to Smith. That's just a little bit behind him. Ryder with it. And that's going to... No, that goes right up to St. John, who's getting out of the box. And here's a sneaky one, and there's... He just misses the net. Big Jake was slid too far, and nice hustle back there by Robinson to keep St. John tied up. Nice play there. Doesn't come outside the line, just about got there. Comes Drover. Drover gets it back to Robinson. Robinson chips it up. That goes to Ford. Ford gets it outside the line. And that's going down to the corner, and that's going to go for an ice. So a little unlucky there.
Lucky 50-50 ticket number for tonight's jackpot, $140. Ticket number 8450930. Once again, that number 8450930. Thank you.
Okay, somebody's got a lucky ticket out there on this Halloween night. That comes around. Pike was waiting for it. He gets that cut off there by Walsh, Brady Walsh. That just bounces over Hoff's stick. And here comes Brady Walsh again. Applin down on him. Walsh goes for a spill. Pike drops him. Here comes Ryder. Ryder with the shot. Goes off Hoff. Pike looked like he was gone for a second there. And puck just got tied up. Nice play there by Applin. He takes the hit. Gets it up to Hoff. Gets it over to Ford. Kings can't get it out. Comes back to Applin. He's going to get that over to Pike. Pike, nice pass over to, nice pack over to Ford. Ford skating in. Ford still with the puck. Sharp angled shot. So it looks like another penalty here. So Vallis is now leaving the net. He was looking for, didn't see the single from the coaching staff. That'll go for a penalty, or go for a whistle here, I would expect. No. Kings come up with it. Pike with it. Smith with the puck. Gets it back up to O'Neill. This is a delayed penalty here. And there's a tip, and that goes wide. Power on it. Power. Okay, so that's it. Brady Walsh goes over and checks power, takes him off the puck, and Kings are going to go on the power play at the 12:01 minute mark here in the third period, down three. Up on the shots on goal, so Kings have been out shooting them this period so far. So shots are 31-29, and Walsh is going to go to the box on the high stick. Okay, looks like Park and Bitch on the draw. Park wins that again. He's been good on that all night. Here comes O'Neill. O'Neill gets it back, gets it over to King, tries to take it off his skate. Park battling back there. Park comes up with it. Park drives. Comes back to O'Neill. O'Neill with the puck. O'Neill gets that over to King. King gets it back to Ryan. Ryan Reed. Into Campbell. Campbell with the shot. And Growlers did a good job playing their position there. O'Neill with it. Minute 26 left to go here in this power play.
O'Neill skates it up, gets it across, gets it over to King, that goes off, over to Park. O'Neill down to Park. Park taking his time, gets it into O'Neill. O'Neill tries to flick it over, and that goes off a stick and right into Ryan. Ryder and O'Neill take a tumble back there. Okay, so they break up the scrum. One thing I've noticed this year, with the new rule, the new COVID rules for hockey in Newfoundland, the scrums are a non-starter. That'll result in 4 minutes unsportsmanlike. And we've seen a lot less of them. So not sure that's a bad thing for hockey. Not a bad thing for hockey. Okay, no more Wells and Martel here on the draw. Dix has it. And Normore Wells and Martel are going after, and Martel is swinging. He's not hitting anything. Oh, he's still swinging. Okay, well. Okay, they're both going to go to the box on that one, and they attempted to fight. Not sure what you get for that. So that's Normore Wells and Martel. Both have played a good game. Martel's got himself a few points tonight. Well, the refs want to sort this one out. Kings are currently on a power play. 3 minutes left in that. Let's see how this shakes out, and they're they're explaining it down there to the to Noftel and Smith. They'll bring that information back to the bench. Smith wants further clarification on the swing and the miss by Martel. Okay, still sorting it out. Explanations going back to the bench. We'll see what happens here on the call. Haven't seen that gesture yet. May have to wait for this, for the scorekeeper's announcement on this one. Okay, well, we got an open gate here, and not sure about this. It looked to me like Martel had taken the initial penalty, and then there was a bit of pushing, and then there were some swings thrown, and we got Gould in the box. So 4-on-4. So that looks like it's it for the Kings. Looks like it's it for the Kings power play. Homer Wells gets a 2. It's up on the board, and that gets shot down the ice, and that's going to go for an icing.
Growlers penalty to number 12, Kyle Martel. 2 minutes roughing and a 10-minute misconduct. Time of the penalty on 8:56. Kings penalty to number 17, Michael.
Okay, well, the Kings come out on the wrong end of that one. The they got an extra one for so they both get roughing. Martel and Martel gets roughing. There's a pass that goes up to Elliot Dix. He's speeding down the sideline. That is the shot. He scores. There we go. That's what we wanted if you're a Kings fan. 5-3. Elliot Dix. Nice pass there by Ben Smith up the sidewall. Here we go. We'll take a look at this play again. Here comes Dix coming down through. St. John is on him, and that just goes underneath the pad and the glove of Clay Ryan, who's been stellar all night here. There's the shot, and nice shot it is. That goes, that finds Quine. So it's not over yet. Those of you thinking about turning off your laptops, you can keep them going. Okay, 5-3. Still a two-goal deficit, but I like to see no quit in these Kings. Here comes Drover. Drover with the puck. Drover shoots that in. That comes up the wall. Comes up to Hiscock. Robinson tries to play that. Hiscock comes up with it. Okay, they gave that one to Dix from Drover. They got half it right. That was Dix from Ben Smith on the nice pass, and the Kings are going back to the box here. So that's the third penalty. Kyle Campbell on a trip. So this is going to be 4-on-3 for 8 seconds, and then it's going to be 5-on-3. So it's this is going to be a tough patch here. Kings are going to be lucky to get out of this at the 10-minute mark. They're going to need to survive this to move on here. That is a great block, so Jack O'Neill comes up with a block on that. Here's Ryder with the puck. Ryder gets it, Ryder. Hiscock drops it back. Here's Walsh with it. Walsh gets that down to the corner, and there's the attempt. Power with it, Power with the time. He flicks that around, and that's going to go down. So that's what the Kings wanted to see. So this is going to be a 5-on-3 for another 33 seconds. Ryder with it. Ryder gets it over to Brady Walsh. Brady Walsh with the puck. He sets it up here in the zone, slides that over to Dyke. Dyke's gonna just let that go back to Ryder. Gets it over to Walsh. Walsh with the puck. Walsh back up to Ryder. And that's gonna come out, and Jack O'Neill's gonna be first on that. He's gonna shoot it down, so that should kill the 5-on-3. Okay, so 55 seconds left in the Campbell trip. Dyke with the puck, dueled out of the box. Dyke with it, Dyke skating up through. He runs into a crowd. And Big Jake's gonna hold on to that one. So just calm everything down here for a second. So King's gonna get some more fresh legs out here. Robinson with it. Robinson shoots that down the ice. It comes back to St. John. St. John with the puck here now. King's still on the penalty. Phil. Witten comes in. Witten from a sharp angle. That goes off the post. So that was a tricky shot. Missed everything but the post. There's a nice play by Park. Park's got it. Park skating it down. He's got Smith with him. Nice play there by Witten. Nice play there by Park. He tries to slide it out in front. Great hustle there by Johnny Park. Comes down, fights through the hit. We're back to even strength. Smith with it now. Back to Applin. Applin gets it over to Robinson. Oh, that goes right off of Growler, right in front of the net. That could have been dangerous. Up to Hoff. Hoff up to Ford. Ford gets it over to Pike, and that's a tip, so there's going to be no icing on that call. Pike with it. Now Pike tries to slide that out front. Hoff is on it. Hoff with the puck. Back to O'Neill. O'Neill with the shot. That goes wide. There's a tip. That goes right into the corner. Hoff battling Ford here. Comes up to O'Neill. O'Neill with the shot. That goes wide. Drover's going to be on that one. Tips that back down to Pike. Pike tries to flick it over to Ford. Hoff jumps in. Hoff comes up with it. Nice play by Hoff, and he goes for a spill. And that's going to be a penalty. Okay, that looks like Shepard. So Shepard, I think, on a cross check. Okay, so the Kings are going back to the power play at the 7-11 mark here. Okay,
so let's see if the Kings can capitalize on this. They got one earlier on the Elliott Dix goal. Elliott takes that draw. Tried to shoot that around. King is going to keep it in. King with the puck. King gets it over to O'Neill. O'Neill with it now. O'Neill dumps it down to Reed. Ryan Reed with the puck. Gets it down to Dix. Dix with it. Back to Reed. Reed with a shot, and that goes bouncing off. Nice play there, holding a stick. Nice play by King. Gets it back up to Dix. Dix with it. Dix brings it back into his own zone. Gets it over to King. King now gets it up to O'Neill. O'Neill looking for Hoff, and he got him. Oh, that's Dix. Dix with the puck. Dix slides it across. And there's a goal! And that's a good goal! Western Kings on the power play. Nice play there by Elliott Dix. Nice tip there by, I think it was Smith, to get the goal. So Kings are back in this one. Let's take a look at the replay. Dix, that goes straight up in the air. And, yep, so that's Ben Smith assisted by Elliott Dix. So that was the combination on the last two goals. We got a 5-4 game with 6:32 left. So stay tuned. Getting a little spooky out there if you're a Growlers fan. Okay, here's Park with it. Picked up by St. John. St. John just circles around the net. Picked up by Connor. Connors goes high off the glass, and that should go for... And that should go for four and ice.
Time of the goal, 13:28. That's Smith from Dix at 13:28.
Okay, 6:04 left here, so there's been no quit after what I probably will call the worst period I've seen the Kings play all year in the second, and that's not to take it away from the Growlers. They played a great, but that was their best period I've seen them play this series. So 5-4 hockey game in the late stages here. Walsh comes down, Drover's on him, puck slides down, Campbell got it. Okay, somebody got the 50-50 ticket, here comes Campbell. Campbell gets it up, and Campbell with the puck. Can Campbell put it in? A nice save there by Ryan. Great play there by Campbell, back to Park. Park with a shot. Oh, and Hoff had the wide open net, just shoots it high. Kings with all the pressure at the moment. St. John with the puck. That comes high off the glass. That's going to go back to Drover. King's making a change. Robinson with it. Robinson still with the puck. Robinson comes in. Leaves it for Hoff. Hoff now gets knocked off it by Hiscock. Campbell going over. Plays that. Connors dumps that out. Little bouncer there. Robinson's first on it. Nice move by Robinson. He takes a little spill. A little foot race here. Walsh with it, and Ford's going to take a penalty on that one. So Kings didn't want that. Like the hustle, like the effort, and just happens to get the stick in the feet of Walsh, and Growlers going back on the power play. Okay, so the Growlers got Noftel, Fisher, Connors, Ryder and Walsh out here for their power play group. Kings got Applin, Dix, O'Neill, and Pike out killing this penalty. That's played by, it's going to be played by Ryan. Comes straight around. Dumped back in. Connors picks it up. Dix put some pressure on and Connors lost it momentarily. Dix turned the other way. Nice stick there by O'Neill. Pike tries to take the hit. Connors doesn't flinch for that one. Nice play there. Applin steps up. Nice play there by Dix. And no arm. Oh, baby. Oh, baby, baby, baby. Here come the Growlers. There's the... Okay, that's disappointing. I hate to be critical here, but that looked like there was a trip, so my humble opinion, that goal would have never happened, so but it did. That's not how it went, and David Fisher gets the goal. David Fisher puts the David Fisher puts them up 6-4, back to a two-goal lead here. Okay, that comes sliding down the ice. Power picks it up. Power gets it up to Smith. Smith with the puck, gets it over to Park. Park coming with some speed. He dumps that in. Shepherd on him, gets it back up. Comes it back up to Robinson. Robinson loses it for a second, keeps it. Dumps that back in, little bouncer. And that's going to be held by Ryan.
Assisted by number 21, David Fisher. Time of the goal, 15:54.
Okay, well, they called that.
Second of the game, assisted by Fisher.
Yeah, they got that call wrong. So they're saying Noftel from Fisher, but that was Fisher all the way. He just got that one backwards. Here's Park. Park tries to slide it over to Power. Power picks it up, dumps it back in. Smith has it. Nope, Smith almost had it. Look at the puck here now. Here's Gould with it. Gould looking to center that. He's back up to the line. There's Power with the shot.
10:15 a.m.
Okay, so they announced tomorrow's game. So tomorrow's game will be in the Kinsman Arena, and that'll be at 10:15. That will not be on Rogers TV this week, so hoping to have the Kinsman games broadcast, talking with Gian and his crew. And they've got some more fiber op to run before we can get active out there. So that'll happen before this season's over. And again, thanks to Rogers for everything they do. Very much appreciated for Gian and his team. And it certainly helps with the league, helps with midget hockey. And here comes this one here, and that could have been dangerous. King with it. King gets it back. So just about 2 minutes to go here. A little better, 2:20 to go here in the third period. King's down by two on the Fisher goal. Hiscock with it now. Gets it over to Vitch. Vitch with the puck. Vitch skates in over the line. King looked to take him. Nice play by O'Neill. Separating the man from the puck. Ryder with it now. Ryder gets it up to Walsh. Let's dump back in. Parkey with it. Parkey loses his feet. Gonna call Walsh on a trip there, but might be a makeup call for the earlier one because that Parkey just lost his footing on that one. Nevertheless, the Kings are going to go up on the power play with a minute 44 to go, down two goals. So the face-off is going to be in the Growlers' end, and right now we'll see what the signal is. See if they're going to pull Big Jake. There's the face-off. Connor's with it. Connor shoots that around. O'Neill is going to be there. O'Neill gets it over to King. King with the puck, slides it in, there's the shot, and that just goes wide. Smith on it, Smith gets it back to Ryan Reed. Comes up the sidewall, and O'Neill pinching on that one.
2 minutes for boarding.
Okay, King with it.
2 minutes for boarding at 18:60.
Ooh, it's called boarding. Okay, so 2 minutes for boarding for Walsh. Here's King with it. And that gets outside the line, so the King's got about a minute left to go here in this game. Gets it over to O'Neill. They're going to need to go. Okay, so Vallis is gone. Extra attack is coming on, and there's a shot. That just goes high. Kings dump it back in. 53 seconds to go. They need to get on the board here quick. Here's Reed with a shot, and there's the tip. And right out front, and couldn't get a stick on it. Wide open. Oh! And another one wide open. This puck is still kicking around. Still bouncing out there. Puck is still alive. Both teams battling for it. And he scored! Did that go in? Oh, that must have hit the side of the net. Look from here, from this angle, that was in, but didn't cross the line, I guess. So good hustle, good attempt. That would have been big. 31 seconds left. Okay, well, I like the fight in the Kings. They fought back in this third period. They didn't quit. And that's just as important. 2 points would have been big against the Growlers at home, but after that second period, after that second period, the Kings needed to do something to get back in this, and they did that. So that bodes well for tomorrow. No quitting them. There's no quitting the Growlers last night either. Growlers were down, and they fought back. Had the goalie pulled late, and battling to tie that one up. So we got a timeout here. Net is still empty, so we got both goalies out of the net for the Kings, and we're gonna go with the extra attacker. So it's gonna be the all-important face-off. Important face-off on this one. Kings got 31 seconds left and down by two, so that's a steep climb. They're going to need to win this, get it in, and put the puck in the net pretty darn quick here. Okay, Park on it. Park wins the draw. There's Campbell. Campbell gets it over and gets it to Pike. Pike with the puck. Leaves that for Campbell or O'Neill. There's Park with it, and there's a tip, and that just goes high. 15 seconds left. Growlers doing what they need to do. Tie that up in the corner. Both teams battling for it here. And not sure what the call was there. Nevertheless, 8 seconds left, and this is probably... only thing left for tonight is a little bit of dress up and maybe some candy and a bag of chips or something. Okay, Park on the draw. 8 seconds left. Kings down by two. Ryder with it. Ryder's just going to seal that in the corner. Both teams battling for it. Get out of the shenanigans and call this one a night. 0.9 seconds left. I would have just ran the clock on that one. Okay, good call on running the clock. And that's it. So Growlers take the second game. The rubber match is tomorrow morning, 10:15 in the Kinsman Arena. So we'll see you next time. Again, thanks to the Rogers crowd, and happy Halloween, everyone.
Call the Rogers TV viewer response line, email us, or connect with us on social media.
Sports fans know Sundays are for football. That's why you need NFL Sunday Tickets. With NFL Sunday Ticket, you'll get every live game every Sunday all season long. More plays, more action, more to love, live in HD. Order NFL Sunday Ticket for only $199.99. Get up to 200 regular season games every Sunday afternoon. Call 1-888-ROGERS-1 today.
Much emphasis has been on the hospital. It's because we've had a hospital that was built in the 1970s. It was ready to be, basically demolished back in 15 years ago.
Right.
So we really needed to do this. We needed long-term care facilities. And at a time and an era when dollars were pretty scarce, we were able to, again, assert ourselves.
Yeah.
And get what we needed. We right. now have a $750 million contract that's been for the construction and operation of our hospital. But that's not the final touches to a community. We have the Newfoundland and Labrador Summer Games coming in short order, in a very short mm-hmm. period of time. Building up our recreational infrastructure, building up our capacity to do sport tourism, mm-hmm. building up our capacity to be able to really host tourists and tourism more effectively is something that's on my mind. But you know what's really on my mind is making sure that our children have great places to go to school, that they have playgrounds that are safe, that are nurturing, that we have those basic elements of a successful community. But what right now is occupying most of my time, it's dealing with people one-on-one on their right. own individual issues. In a difficult time, this pandemic has caused an awful lot of stress mm. on an awful lot of people and an awful lot of families.
Yeah.
And it's something you'll never hear about in the news, nor should you,
right.
but it's worth the conversation. A lot of my time is spent making sure that people have the ability to carry on. And
right.
that's something that you'll never ever hear about that in the newspaper or on a newscast.
No, and it's unfortunate, and because I think that hearing that, you know, yourself, for instance, you're taking part and you're ensuring that in the community, gives a sense of hope for those that are struggling and that are going through a difficult time to say, hey, I can reach out to my MHA.
Well, and it's important
I can talk
to
Jerry about that.
So you got your fundamentals, mm-hmm. With the hospital. Now, for the next 4 years, about $10 million will be dispersed every month
wow.
in that project alone. The trickle down, the economic impact of that throughout the entire community mm-hmm. is very, very real. And we're feeling it. You go to, some of the equipment rental agency, companies and so on. You talk to them about how business, the economy is going. Now, listen, that does not mean it's working for everybody. Mm-hmm. So this is some of the two sides of this. You got to keep the economy going. And that was part of my strategic mentality, my strategic mindset. Get this project going now. It'll buffer the economy of Corner Brook for many, many years to come, while the entire province or the entire country may suffer some ups and downs. We will have a basis for a steady, steady economy. The mm-hmm. Corner Brook Pulp and Paper, our paper mill, takes a huge amount of my time, because you've got to get the fundamentals right. You've got to nurture the company without subsidies,
right.
But you've got to make sure that this company has the ability to stay in business in a very, very competitive newsprint world. So that occupies a lot of my time. But when you get those fundamentals correct,
what you do is you
create the time to be able to make sure that our seniors are protected and nurtured.
Absolutely.
And they have the resources to be able to maintain a high standard of living. Because you know what? We've got to protect our young families.
Yeah.
We're doing that in large measure, you know, by things such as our daycare program, our $25 daycare program, enabling young families to be able to feel safe, to be able to, and for both, you know, if there's two, you know, members of the family, two parents, that both parents can enter the workforce. If it's a single family, single parent family, that they can enter the workforce with comfort, knowing their children mm-hmm. are protected and nurtured. So we do that, but we also have to understand that our seniors, which are the bedrock of our community, also face vulnerabilities, and that takes up a lot of my time, and it's part of my time that I really enjoy having taken up.
Yeah, I can imagine. I know myself, one of my favorite things to do is just find elderly people that have been here, have grown up, and talking to them. My little girl, she's going to be 8 in a couple of months. She has an arts and crafts show on Rogers that she does arts and crafts. And in the first episode she did, she made these little greeting cards for some of the seniors up at the Westmount Estates, and got a really wonderful feedback from that, and we've since remained connected with them and so on, because I feel that the other part, aside from ensuring their health and safety, it's also their mental health. And I think a lot of the seniors that I've spoken to since my little girl and I have done that show are alone, and they feel really lonely.
So let's make a connection here. You're absolutely right. It's one thing to do things for seniors.
Mm-hmm.
It's another thing to do them with seniors.
Yes.
So let's go back to where we started here.
Mm-hmm.
Community gardens. Who can teach young people the best ways to garden?
Yeah.
Our seniors got skills that you would never ever imagine that anyone could have when it comes to, you know, gardening and crafts and some of our best athletes that I could ever imagine are the seniors of today, the historic. That's why, you know, the gathering places within our city are changing. There's not so much. Remember when we had the Knights of Columbus Hall? Remember when we had some of the bigger, you know, some of the bigger halls?
Yes.
Sort of, you know, the Legion is still a powerhouse of gathering. The Elks Lodge is still a powerhouse of gathering. But our gathering places are becoming a little bit fewer and farther between.
Mm.
So that's not to say that they're not as important. Our new gathering places are starting to become the places where young people can rub shoulders and be with and laugh and share stories with older folks,
right,
our seniors, and that's how you generate true sense of community.
I think so too. You did mention that there were three community gardens. You mentioned the locations. Yeah. Is there anywhere that people can kind of, anywhere online or any way that they can find out if there's new gardens going up, where they're going to be going, where they're going to appear? Is there any kind of a database?
I'm delighted that there was a young student, Nick Hines, who worked at Fisheries, Forestry, and Agriculture, which is headquartered here in Corner Brook. The Provincial Department of Agriculture is based here. A young student by the name of Nick Hines, who worked as a summer student, he created a guidebook for developing a community garden, and actually started to generate a map of potential places where community gardens could be located, and created a template for how to apply for funding to be able to help generate a community garden. And I'm going to be launching that community garden guide for Corner Brook in the coming weeks.
Oh wow.
Yeah, and it was a partnership. He sought input from the Western Environment Center, from the Corner Brook Extreme Trail, from the city of Corner Brook and their planners, their city planners, and he generated this kind of manual or document, how to make Corner Brook into the garden capital of the Newfoundland and Labrador. And so awesome. I'll be launching that very, very shortly.
That is awesome. Well, guys, make sure you keep an eye out for that book when it launches, and be sure to get a copy of it so you can find that. I know I will be, and I'll be looking forward to it. I want to thank you so much for being here today, Jerry, and for sharing a little bit about you as a community member, and a little bit of what you're doing for this community that I agree you and I both love so much and care so much about. So thanks for being here today.
My pleasure.
And for all of you watching, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye for now.